What's up, everyone, and welcome to the club. In today's video, we're creating a sketch illustration of a snow leopard. Let's begin today's lesson by sketching a circle in the center of our page to define the size of the head. Now, I'm going to use a side grip using the flat edge of our pencil. Let's start from the very top. It's going to work our way around the left side, coming in towards the center. And then we'll go all the way around the right side. Let's add some guidelines around our circle. Starting from the very top, I'm just going to sketch a line coming all the way down towards the bottom of our page. Now we're going to add another guideline going across from left to right. Let's start from the center of our circle, go all the way out, and stretch that across towards the right side. Now halfway between that center of our circle and the right side, we're going to sketch an oval for the eye, going around and then back up. Now I'm going to overlap a straight line on top of that oval. So we're going to step down, extend this out towards the left, in towards the right side. And then on the right side, angle this down and out. Let's go to the right side of our circle, draw a straight angle line, coming down and then out to right about there. Angle this back down and in towards the bottom of the chin. And then pull this up and in towards the bottom of our circle. Now I'm going to draw the ear on the top left side of our circle. Let's start from the center, draw a straight angled line, going up and extending that out towards the end. From the top of that line, draw a straight angled line coming down, and pull that back down and in toward the left side of our circle. Now from here, we're going to add some shape to the top of the head. Let's start on the right side, draw a straight line going up. I'm just going to curve this up and in toward the top of our circle. And continue that curve up and out in behind the ear. Now let's go to the right side of the ear, curve the neck going out and then down. Let's go to the bottom of the head, curve the neck coming down and then bending that out. Now that we have the basic shape of the head, let's move over towards the right side and draw on the nose. We start from this point, draw a straight line coming in, angle this back down and out. And then from the bottom right of our circle, curve the mouth coming down, and then just bend that up towards the bottom of the nose. Once we've established the basic shape of our drawing, let's go back and lightly erase some of these guidelines. Now we're going to switch to the side edge of our pencil and add some fur along the top edge of the eye. Let's start from the outside. I'm just going to curve this down, across that line, and over towards the right. And then going back to the tip of our pencil, draw the bottom edge of the eyelid coming down towards the bottom of our oval. And go across. Let's trace the right side of the eye going up underneath the brow. Let's add in the pupil, just tucking that up underneath the brow, and we'll just fill that in. And then we'll lightly shade in the top and just fade that down. I'm just going to darken up the inside of the eye, coming down towards the bottom, and just extend this line coming down. Now from here, we're just going to add some shading and some stripes and pattern across the eye. Going up. Just pulling that in towards the front of the head. Just working our way out towards the edge of the head. And we'll just continue our way down towards the tip of the nose. Going back to the tip of our pencil, we're just going to add a fur texture along the outside of the brow. Just adding these short little lines going up above the head and just pulling that back. add some shape to the top edge of the nose, starting in the middle, and down the side, and then up. And then with the side edge of a pencil, we're just going to darken up the nose. Just go a little bit darker on the inside on the left, and then we'll gradually fade that out. I'm just going to trace out the mouth, going up towards the corner, and lightly adding that fur texture across the chin and down towards the bottom. I'm just going to go back and darken up the edge of the mouth. Start to add that shading on the top. And then roughly adding in those stripes across the whiskers. Now we're going to move up and continue to add that fur texture across the top of the head, going towards the ear. And then adding some shape to the ear. Just taking out the sharp corners, rounding out the top, and pulling that back in. And we'll continue that fur across the back. Now from the base of the ear, we're just going to trace that circle with this fur texture going around. Pull that in towards the chin, and we'll add that fur texture across the front of the neck. Now we're going to go back and start adding an even shade to the inside of the neck and head area. Starting on the left side. Now this is a rough treatment and we'll come back and add some more detail after. So you see that I'm working with the curve of the neck. Just pulling these down. And just gradually bending that out towards the right. Continue along the top, adding this fur texture with the tip of our pencil. I'm just going to darken up the inside of the ear and fade that down, and going back and adding that fur texture, just working my way towards the back. We're going to darken up that shadow underneath the head, across the neck. And then we'll darken up the back. Some darker tones for the spots across the body. Starting across the bottom of the head, just blocking in these spots. Add those spots inside the head, starting from the jaw, working our way towards the eye. Then adding some smaller ones along the inside. Now we're going to go in and add another pass of detail across the mouth. Now we're just refining the shadow areas of the head. Now we're working in a very light fur texture with a tip of pencil across the head. adding a layer of fur texture on top of those spots. And now we're adding some definition to the head shape by adding some more shadows. and we'll soften up the edge of the fur using the side edge of our pencil. And as we get near the end of our drawing, we'll tighten up our shadows and add a little bit more fur detail. And that's pretty much it. There's a sketch illustration of a snow leopard. I hope you enjoyed today's lesson. If you did, please make sure you subscribe because I'm posting new lessons every single day. You can also drop your requests in the comments below. I want to thank you for watching, and I'll see you again soon.